Yes, on your feet. Yes. Only one of us gets a box of water, though. So, yes, I'm so excited to get to ask you about your insane brain and made this amazing movie. I gather you guys liked it as much as I did. because we're all writers here, I want to start by asking you about the writing process. And I know you usually, I think, on all of your features, have you written with somebody? I'm trying to think. Yeah, you've always partnered. So can you talk, first of all, generally about how do you approach a writing partnership, and then maybe specifically with this, how this started and what that the writing process was like?
그 코라이터가 항상 크레딧에 같이 있긴 한데 직접 같이 테이블에 앉아서 쓰지 못하는 타입이에요. 혼자 쓰는 타입이라 제가 스토리라인을 써서 주고 그쪽이 드래프트를 한번 쓰면 그 다음에 그거 한번 보고 나는 또 쓴다거나 이런 식으로 주거니 받거니 한 명씩 번갈아가면서 쓰다가 이제 결국 최종적으로는 제가 혼자 쓰는데 이번 패러사이트도 비슷한 경우였고요.
So I always do work with a co-writer, but it's not as if we sit down on a table together and write. I always try to write by myself. It would go, you know, I would write a treatment of it and then give it to the writer. He would come back with a draft and I would adjust it. And then finally, I would write the final draft on my own.
이 기생충 같은 경우 2015년에 제가 15페이지 정도의 스토리라인을 썼어요. 그걸로 처음 제작사랑 이제 협의도 했고 그랬는데.
So for Parasite, I wrote a 15-page treatment in 2015, and through that, I agreed with the production company to make this project.
그리고서는 이제 제가 업자라는 그 넷플릭스 영화 찍고 있을 동안 그 작가가 그거 가지고 뭐 두 개 정도 드래프트를 써봤었죠.
And so while I was filming the Netflix film 옥자, my co-writer wrote around two drafts based on that treatment.
그 드래프트의 어떤 몇몇 좋은 대사들이 영화에 지금 남아 있는 상태고요.
So some of the dialogue from his drafts are in the final film.
2017년에 제가 이제 혼자 2017년 가을 겨울에 제가 4개월 반 작업을 했는데 거기서 이제 대부분 새롭게 다 다시 썼어요. 특히 그 세 번째 가족 지하실과 벙커 그다음에 오리지널 하우스키퍼가 이제 문광이라는 인물이 돌아오는 거 영화의 후반부가 그때 다 새롭게 다 나왔거든요.
So in the fall and winter of 2017, I spent 4 months writing the script by myself, and a lot of new things came up within that time period. The third family, the bunker, and the moment, from the moment when the original housekeeper comes back, that was all new. So you can say that the second half of the film all came to me at that point.
So during 3 or 4 years, there was no basement, bunker, and husband in the bunker. This is a very simple, rich and poor, two-family story. But in the very last 4 months, everything came, and marketing에서는 감추지만 결국 세 가족.
No. I knew you spoke English perfectly. Keep going. It's a trick.
So we hide it during the marketing process, but this film is actually about three families.
When you sit down to, first of all, when you sit down to write that initial treatment, how do you work? Do you start at the beginning and write forward very organically? Do you outline? Do you structure? How do you approach that initial story phase?
그 말씀드린 것처럼 이제 영화 후반이나 결말 그 최종 목표 시점이 없이 썼기 때문에 그냥 그 네 가족이 부잣집으로 하나씩 인필트레이션 한다. 그 컨셉 자체가 너무 재밌어서 그냥 그 내용만 있었어요. 5페이지짜리. 다 침투한 후에 이들이 어떻게 될 건지에 대해서는 지금의 영화와는 다른 되게 이상한 아이디어들만 이렇게 흐지부지하게 있었고요.
So with Parasite, I didn't know what would happen at the end. It's not as if I had a set ending. And so in my initial treatment, it was only about this one family of four infiltrating another family, and that's the concept that I was fascinated by. What happens after the infiltration, there were very strange ideas here and there, but they were quite ambiguous.
그 뭐야, 네, 알잖아, 다 우리 저기 선수들끼리니까 다 알 텐데 엔딩이나 스트럭처가 없는 상태에서 막 디테일을 쓰다 보면 마음이 불안하잖아요. 근데 그 불안함을 많이 이제 극복할 수 있게 해서 그래서 어떻게든 엔딩이 나오겠지 하면서 썼던. 그러니까 10페이지 후에 이게 어떻게 될지 나도 모르는 상태에서 막 썼었던 거야 사실. 근데 이상하게도 별로 불안하지 않았어요. 스트럭처를 손에 넣게 되리라라는 생각이 있었고.
So you guys all know because you're writers, but when you write all these details without having a set ending or a set structure, you feel very anxious. But with Parasite, for some reason, I didn't feel as anxious. I just knew that it would somehow come to me. I wrote not knowing what would happen 10 pages later on, and I knew that the structure would come to me in the end.
How about you, Ryan? So, no. It's amazing structure. You wanted to have a whole structure from the first day?
I know this trick. I do it in my own Q&As.
There's so many questions he has for Knives Out.
Well, you can, with the next one I do, you can moderate. And then you can... to me, that's fascinating. Do you, with every project, has it been similar, where you write a treatment and then your co-writer takes a pass and then you come in, or is it different project?
그동안 20년간 7편의 작품을 만들었고 다 시나리오를 제가 썼는데 매번 달랐던 것 같아요. 마더 같은 경우는 처음 한 페이지씩 없이 썼을 때부터 이미 그 엔드가 꼴이 딱 정확하게 라스트 씬이 있었던 케이스고요.
So over the past 20 years, I've created 7 films, and I think it was different for all projects. I wrote all the scripts myself. For example, with my previous film, Mother, from the moment I had a one-page synopsis, I had the ending, I had the last scene.
그러니까 시놉시스나 스토리라인을 어떤 프로듀서나 뭐 누구 배우랑 얘기하기 위해서 억지로 쓰긴 쓰지만 그거 자체를 그렇게 믿는 편은 아니에요. 이게 결국은 바뀌게 될 것이다. 일단은 그렇지만 뭐라도 있어야 되니까 괜히 하나 써놓자 뭐 이런 마음이죠.
So I do write, you know, a synopsis or a treatment so that I can show them to the producer and the actors and discuss it with them. But I don't really trust it. I always know that things will change. I just write it for the sake of sharing it.
You also wrote some few pages of synopsis for Knives Out.
Sort of. Wait a minute. This is just sneaky. Try to fill time.
He's just curious.
Okay, we'll talk afterwards. I think we're all much more interested in Paris right now. So what then for you, and I'm sure I know the obvious answer, but given that process and given the fact that you always do collaborate with someone, what is for you is the main benefit of the collaboration then? Because it seems like you do write and you always come in and do like the last pass of it. For you, when you're looking for a writing partner, when you're working with someone, how would you articulate what you're looking to get out of that partnership?
그 친구가 뭐 결과적으로 뭐 양적으로 몇 페이지를 썼다, 뭐 몇십 페이지 이런 거 중요한 것 같지는 않아요. 그런 것들이 비록 작더라도 작은 스파크를 하나 줄 수 있으면 그것만으로도 엄청 큰 도움이 되는 것 같아요.
So I don't think it's important on how many pages my co-writer writes or how much he does on the script. I don't think that's really important. Even if, you know, it's small, as long as they can provide the spark, then that's a partnership that I value.
그 기생충 같은 경우는 그 친구가 써봤던 드래프트 같은 건 영화랑 너무 달라요. 물론 또 지하실 자체라는 것도 없고 그 구조 자체를 다 내가 만들었으니까 너무 다르지만 그 친구가 썼던 드래프트의 어느 한 신에 되게 중요한 어떤 작은 디테일이 하나 있었어요.
So for Parasite, the draft that my co-writer wrote is very different. It's completely different from the finished film because I created the structure and his draft didn't even have the hidden basement. But in his draft, there was one scene that was very important.
그 꼬마애가 그 뭐야 가난한 가족 그 아버지 냄새 맡고 이거 저기 아줌마한테서도 같은 냄새가 났는데? 라고 하는 장면이 있었어요. 그 냄새에 관한 부분이 있어서 그게 아 이게 너무 좋다 그래서 제가 그 부분 그게 하나의 작은 스파크였죠. 그 스파크 덕분에 제가 그거를 영화 후반부 전체로 확장시켜서 이 영화를 지배하는 냄새라는 하나의 되게 중요한 어떤 키워드를 잡아낼 수 있었던 거거든요. 근데 그 친구 드래프트에 어느 작은 한 부분에 거기 살짝 나왔다 지나갔었어요.
So it's a scene where the rich little boy goes to the poor family father and smells him and mentions that he smells exactly like the housekeeper lady. And I really love that part. And it was a small spark that he provided that he kind of just glossed over in his draft. But I used that device and expanded it to construct the second half of the film. And so his small spark became the keyword and device that really dominated the story.
That's fascinating. It's one of the things I love with the movie is that moment and how that leads to the father's disintegration, how he begins to internalize that, the notion that there's something in our pores that is different, you know, that smells different. And then you see that start to break it down. I love that. That's fantastic. And have you worked with different writers for, have you worked with the same collaborator twice with the writers?
일곱 번의 작품에 이제 다 달랐고, 사실은 이게 약간 한국적인 독특한 시스템인데, 그 친구들이 또 연출부로 일을 했으니까, 한국에서 약간 뭐, 스승과 제자라고 하면 웃긴데, 약간 그 선배와 후배, 이렇게, 그리고 그 친구들이 또 감독 데뷔할 때 제가 도와주기도 하고, 뭐, 프로듀서로 참여해주기도 하고, 이런 식으로 약간 그런 가족적인 릴레이션십이 있거든요. 그래서,
So with all my 7 films, my collaborators have been different, and this is a system that's quite unique to the Korean film industry, where they're also my assistant directors. In Korea, we have that sort of mentor-mentee, senior-junior relationship, and you know, when they make their first feature, I would help out, I would participate in their projects as a producer, so we have these family-like relationships.
So, but when you say assistant director, do you mean with you on set the whole time, or not the AD? I don't know if it's a similar.
샤우팅하고 다니는 퍼스트 AD가 아니라 그 AD 중에 제일 막내라든가 아니면은 그 후반 작업에도 참여하는 그 스크립터로서 같이 참여하기도 하죠. 그래서 그 같이 시나리오를 썼던 친구가 그걸 하기 때문에 현장에서 더 좀 편한 면도 있어요.
So it's not, you know, they won't be the first AD that shouts on set. They're usually the youngest assistant director or the script supervisor that will, you know, be with me until post-production. And because, you know, they're the ones that wrote the script, I feel more comfortable on set when they're the scripty.
Yeah, the system is a little bit different from here. It's a very Korean and Japanese style, the structure. Yeah.
Well, I'd like to, I am available for your next film. My card after this. If you get it. I promise I'll open it up for you guys. I wanted to ask we've spent some time on the writing. I want to ask very quickly about a little bit about the production of it. First of all, I wanted to ask about your relationship with your cinematographer, Hong Kyung-pyo, and who you've worked with since Mother, I think, and who also shot, I was looking him up, shot Burning last year, which I was gorgeous, so stunning, yeah. But talk about how you work together, what kind of visual, if you storyboard, you shot list, how do you work with him?
He's a really crazy guy.
Yes.
아름다운 이미지 자체에 항상 사로잡혀 있는 사람이고.
He's always captivated by beautiful images.
97년에 내가 그 조감독 AD 할 때 그 양반이 이제 포커스 플러였었죠.
So in 1997, when I was the assistant director, he was the focus puller.
감독 기뽕은 데뷔를 하고 이제 DP도 데뷔하고 이제 각자의 길을 가다가 마더 때 다시 만난 건데.
So then I made my debut as a director, and he became a cinematographer. We went on our separate ways, and then we started collaborating on Mother.
그 뭐랄까 그 사적인 세계의 생활이 별로 없는 사람. 영화 찍는 것과 이미지에 완전히 사로잡혀 있는 사람이라서 거의 하루에 24시간 밥 먹고 계속 영화 얘기만 하는 사람이고요.
So he has no personal life. His life is dominated by just shooting films and thinking about and conjuring all these images. 24 hours, he's obsessed with film. He eats and then talks about film.
그리고 평소에도 그 스틸 사진을 또 많이 찍는 사람이에요. 촬영 중에도 심지어 세트 사진을 찍고 근데 아주 아름다운 그 이전 영화에서 그분의 사진을 모아서 사진집을 낸 적도 있는데 그만큼 이미지에 매혹되어 있는 사람이고
And he also takes a lot of still photographs in his daily life. He would take photographs on set as well. And a while back, we published a photo book of his photographs. And so, you know, that's how much he's just always fascinated by images.
그래서 그 양반이나 저나 이제 그 같이 로케이션을 막 돌아다니면서 같이 로케이션 스카우팅 하면서 미친 듯이 사진 찍어대는 걸 좋아해요. 그 형이 또 저의 사진도 좋아하고 저도 그 형 사진 좋아하고. 근데 이번 패러사이트에는 좀 문제가 있었죠.
So he and I would go around location scouting and take photographs like crazy. We both like each other's photographs. But with Parasite, we did have one issue.
왜냐하면 이제 영화의 90%가 집에서 벌어지는 일이다 보니까 로케이션이 별로 없고 근데 그 집을 다 만들어야 가난한 집, 가난한 동네, 부잣집 전부 다 셀프였거든요. 그러니까 딱히 사진을 찍을 일이 별로 없는 거예요. 프리 프로덕션 중에. 그래서 둘 다 그것 때문에 되게 괴로웠었고.
Because Parasite, 90% of the story takes place in two houses. And those two houses were all built, the rich house and the poor house, the neighborhood. They were all built, so we didn't have a lot of locations. And so we couldn't take a lot of photographs during pre-production, which, you know, really made us suffer.
그래서 집을 다 지을 때까지는 딱히 할 게 없다 보니까 그 영화에 딱 얼마 안 되는 그 비 올 때, 비 막 쏟아질 때 그 인물들이 이제 탈출해서 내려오는 그 코스 있잖아. 일종의 비 오는 로드무비가 잠깐 되는 시퀀스가 있는데 그게 유일하게 우리가 로케이션을 뭔가 찍을 수 있는 거라 그게 시퀀스가 딱 그 하나의 시퀀스지만 그 로케이션 스카우팅을 엄청 많이 하고 그 사진을 엄청 많이 찍었어. 그래서 약간 밸런스가 안 맞게 과도하게 거기 사진들이 많았었죠.
And because we didn't have anything to do while waiting for the houses to be built, we really focused on scouting the locations for the rain sequence when the Kim family escapes the rich house and then constantly descends. It becomes like a road movie in the rain at that moment. And because those were our only locations, although it was just one sequence, we spent a lot of time scouting and taking photographs. So we took just excessive photographs of those locations.
In the movie, it's just a one sequence, but actually, in the actual location is the combination of seven different locations. But...
So when you show up on set for the day's shooting, from those, from your scouting and from taking pictures and from all of that, do you generally have a visual idea of how you're going to shoot a sequence, or do you block and feel it out on the day? How
Who 뭐랄까 공간을 미리 장악을 하고 세트 디자인을 장악을 한 다음에 제가 직접 스토리보드를 그리는데 아까도 책으로 준 그거대로 찍어요. 그 거기에 이미 이제 모든 그간 우리가 준비한 모든 것들이 다 녹아 들어가 있죠. 그래서 그거 스토리보드 그대로 찍죠.
So I always like to have a full mastery of the space and the sets, and then I draw my storyboards myself based on those spaces. It was actually published into a book. And I shoot according to my storyboard, and all the preparations that we did are reflected in my storyboards.
Nice. Let's open it up. I think everyone probably has a lot of questions. Also, let's give it up for sharing here. It's amazing. Let's start in front, right here.
You've been touring with this film quite a bit, I imagine, both through the United States and Europe. I'm wondering what feedback you get from your audiences, like before you did the film. Did your audiences largely imagine that Korea was a place of mainly middle-class people and nobody has food insecurities or everybody owns the latest electronic devices and no problems?
The question was about like the different feedback he's gotten from screening it around the world and if there's been kind of different things he's noticed.
기본적으로 뭐 영화가 시작할 때부터 이미 어느 정도는 유니버설한 것 같아요. 그러니까 반지하라는 되게 독특한 이상한 이제 한국적인 주거 구조가 나오긴 하지만 거기서 애들이 와이파이를 찾고 있잖아요. 그러니까 그거 보면 이미 전 세계인들이 다 마음이 우리가 늘 하는 짓이잖아요. 와이파이 신호 찾는 게 이미 거기서 마음은 열고 들어간다고 생각은 드는데.
So I think from the very beginning, the film, you know, is somewhat universal because you have this semi-basement home, which is a unique residential structure that exists in Korea, but you have these kids searching for Wi-Fi. And I think the audience sort of opens up their hearts when they see that because we're all constantly searching for Wi-Fi.
영화 전체로 봐도 그 반응은 비슷비슷해요. 제가 뭐 깐느나 뭐 독일이나 호주, 뭐 미국 여러 군데에서 이제 스크리닝을 이제 관객들과 같이 해본 적이 있는데 뭐 웃음을 터뜨리는 부분이나 또 공포감이 뭐 휩쓰는 전반적으로 비슷한 것 같고요.
But I think generally the reactions have been quite similar. I've had the opportunity to join the audience and watch the film at Cannes, Germany, Australia, and the US. And people laugh at similar moments and they gasp at similar moments.
약간 특이한 거는 독일에서 조금 미는 영화제스트에 좀 이상한 반응이 있었죠.
So the only strange reaction that I noticed was in Germany during the Munich Film Festival screening.
그 마지막에 냉장고 열고 그 소시지랑 맥주 얘기할 때 광적인 폭소가 거기서
In the last moments of the film, when Kitek opens up the fridge and talks about how not all Germans eat sausage and beer, people just exploded out laughing.
If you can get the Germans laughing, you're doing something right. Let's help the back members here, right there. Yeah. Now it's you. Yeah.
The architect's house, did you design it specifically for filming? And was all the above ground interiors practical?
Mm. 그 부잣집 전체를 다 우리가 만들었죠, 당연히. 근데 이제 그 저는 건축 전문가도 아니고 대신 이제 우리 프로덕션 디자이너한테 그런 부탁만 했죠. 이제 뭐 인물이 여기 있을 때 뭐 이렇게 숨어서 엿들을 수 있어야 되고 뭐 마루에서 이렇게 기어가면 지하 주차장으로 또 탈출할 수 있어야 되고 이런 아주 기본적인 블로킹 라인들 있잖아요. 그것만 가능한 구조는 이제 그것이 가능한 구조를 처음부터 부탁을 했죠. 그 외에 이제 집의 자체의 인테리어나 아름다운 디자인은 이제 우리가 이제 미술 감독이 한 건데. 예.
So we created the rich house from scratch. I'm not an architect, so I had to ask the production designer to come up with the specific designs. But I did have, you know, very specific requests related to the story where if the character is here, she should be able to hide and eavesdrop. If someone is crawling from the living room, they should be able to escape through the garage. So in regards to these basic blocking requirements, I had them for the production designer, production designer, and then he had to come up with the actual interior design of the house.
이제 그 기본적인 스트럭처 제가 부탁한 게 있는데 그거를 이제 실제 건축가가 본 거예요. 실제 건축가한테 이제 어드바이스를 구했으니까 미술감독이. 근데 이제 건축가가 이건 말이야. 이 집을 이렇게 짓는 사람은 없다. 바보들 이렇게 하지. 그래서 건축가의 관점에서 봤을 땐 그런 거예요. 그래서 아마 미술감독이 저랑 그 아키텍트 중간에서 아마 되게 난처했을 거예요. 근데 역시 미술감독이란 게 참 그 마술사와 같은 건 게 이제 저희가 원하는 걸 다 들어주면서도 영화에서 이제 건축적으로 봤을 때도 믿을 만한 그런 식의 집을 만들어낸 거죠.
So I had all these requests in terms of the basic structure of the house, and the production designer took them to an actual architect for a consultation, and the architect was like, this is ridiculous. Only idiots would build a house like this. So it didn't make sense from an architect's perspective, and I'm sure the production designer had a really difficult time between me and the architect, but you know, a production designer is like a magician. He managed to satisfy all my requests while making sure that the house is believable architecturally.
그래서 이번에 그 오스카 후보가 돼서 되게 기쁘더라고요.
So I was so happy when he was nominated for an Academy Award.
Yeah. I think we're getting to the end of the line here. I wanted to ask though, because there was a recent announcement about the television series. What's up with that?
그거 처음부터 제가 구상했던 거예요. 왜냐면 시나리오 쓸 때 이게 저의 아이패드에 이제 되게 많은 아이디어들이 있었어요, 이미. 개별 인물들에 대해서 또 씬들 사이사이에 대해서.
So that was something that I actually had in mind from the very beginning. When I was writing the script, I had so many ideas in my iPad about all these individual characters and things that could happen in between the scenes.
For example, when original housekeeper came back in the late night, her face is, something happened in her face.
Yeah.
But movie never explained that. But I already have a story about that. all those kind of things I will.
다담 맥케이한테 다 던져주려고. 네가 알아서 해봐라. He's gonna throw them all to Adam McKay. Do what you want with them.
그래서 그리고 처음 그 잡을 소개해준 민혁이란 영화에서 민이라고 나오죠. MIA에서 타이틀인데 그 민혁이란 인물과 애초에 그 부잣집 부인과 뭔가 미묘한 뉘앙스가 그들 사이에 무슨 일이 있었던 것 같아. 그리고 그 원래 그 아키텍트였던 램 남궁 현장 램과 오리지널 하우스키퍼 관계는 뭘까? 왜 그 여자한테만 지하 씨를 보여줬을까? 이런 스토리들이 많이 아이디어들이 있어요. 근데 이제 그게 2시간짜리 영화에서는 다 할 수 없는 거였죠. 그래서 6시간짜리 영화를 만들어 보고 싶은 상황이 있어요. 그래서 리미티드 시리즈를 일종의 저는 그냥 그거를 더 긴 시간의 영화라고 생각하고 있어요.
So, for example, you have the character Min who first introduces the tutoring job to Gyu, and it feels like there was something subtle that happened between him and the rich housewife. We don't know what happened, but something did. And then also the original rich architect, Nam Gung Hyun-ja, and the original housekeeper, what is their relationship? Why is she the only person who knows the existence of this bunker? And these are all these things that I couldn't convey into the 2-hour film. So my hope is to create a 6-hour long movie with this limited series.
Take my money! 감사합니다. 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 감사합니다.